Okay, inshallah ta'ala, we come to cover the last slide of the Umrah ritual acts, inshallah ta'ala. So we finished the pillars of Umrah, Ihram, Tawaf, and Sa'i. Now, this is the last act, which is considered to be wajib. Of course, with different disagreement, but here we're talking about the general rule of Umrah, inshallah ta'ala, what is mainly accepted, inshallah, that it becomes wajib or mandatory, inshallah, for the cutting of hair, and that is the last act of Umrah to get out of the state of Ihram. So, ending the state of Ihram for tamattu', format of Hajj, and that is to shorten the hair or shave it. So basically, if you decide to shorten the hair, it needs to be a haircut, meaning that it is from the sunnah for you to take hair from all over your head, not just one part as some brothers do, and one part here, or some brothers do by shaving one part and leaving the other until after Hajj. This is not acceptable, because it's haram to shave one area of the head and leave the other. That does not look right, but rather it's a general haircut that goes from all over your hair, basically takes it from all over your head, basically just general haircut, or that you shave your hair completely. Those who are doing tamattu', it is recommended for you, since you're going to be doing this act twice, is for you to have a haircut or to shorten your hair and then leave the shaving after to the next step of shaving, and that is during Hajj time. So you shorten during Umrah, you shorten your hair, and you shave after, you know, during the Hajj rituals. However, if you decide to shave, that is perfectly fine, alhamdulillah, and then whatever hair grows in those few days that you stay or during the Hajj rituals, you shave them again during Hajj, after the Sa'i of Hajj, and you shave your hair so you can get also out of the state of Ihram. So haircut or shaving. In general, shaving for men is considered highly recommended. Prophet ﷺ gave great blessings for those that shave their hair. And for those who cut their hair, they got also blessings, but less blessings than those who actually shave it off. Basically, shaving means that you need to use the razor. So like here, this picture using a machine, that's not considered to be shaving, because this just shortens the hair. It makes it very short, but it's still, it's not shaving. Shaving means that you actually use the razor and it becomes completely bald, smooth on the skin. Now this is for the brothers. For the sisters, basically, as you can see in this picture, if the hair is really tight, basically you can cut. It's considered or recommended like a finger joint, like this size, a finger joint, that this is the length of what should be taken off or cut off from the hair. If the hair is basically not put together and it's really straight and it is loose, like you see in this picture, so basically it's recommended for you to take one line, not just one part, but rather one straight line, again with the length of a joint finger. So you give that estimation and you cut one straight line for the sisters from the bottom or end of braid. So if it's braided, you can just cut like this picture. If it's not braided, then you can go just straight one cut. Doing the shortening of hair, when you do the haircut, this is basically the last act of the Umrah rituals that will get you out of the state of Ihram. Get you out of the state of Ihram, and it basically ends your state of Ihram. So now after this act, you are basically back to the normal state of Hil. All the restrictions that applied before at the time of Ihram Niyya at the Miqat, all the restrictions that we talked about, now an end come to these restrictions. That's it, you are done. Alhamdulillah, you make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept inshaAllah, and now you can go back to your residence and take a shower and basically change your clothes and put on normal clothes. There are no more restrictions, and you go back to normal state of hell, and you stay in that normal state of hell without no restrictions until the eighth day of Dhul Hijjah, or what we call Yawm al-Tarwiyah. Yawm al-Tarwiyah, this is where you basically go from Mecca and you start your Ihram and Niyyah in Mecca and you go to Mina. This is where you start now a different state of Ihram for Hajj. And we will talk about this inshaAllah ta'ala in our next session. وجزاكم الله خيرا سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.